Coach, assuming you win one of your final two, is it kind of nice to know you could be home for five straight now?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, important that we get one of these next two so we can secure home court and the regular season title, which is a big deal. And obviously one of our goals coming into the season. So pretty close and two tough opponents here. So we're going to have to, play well. But hopefully we can get one of the next two.
How do you combat the defensive strength of Stony Brook with so many talented guys who play down low?
Yeah, you know, they are a very good defensive team. I think statistically, you know, we're 1-2 in almost every category. And so they're athletic and they play hard. And, we'll have to be strong with the ball and make the extra pass, much like we did the first time we played them. And, it's a toughness game is a big part of it. Down low, dealing with their big guys, their physicality, and then on the perimeter, dealing with their athleticism and aggressiveness.
Given the loss to UMBC and then you had a fight to beat Binghamton, what's this week been like in terms of practice, in terms of the guys kind of rebounding from that last stretch?
Yeah, it's been good to have practice time. You know, it's been a lot. You know, three games on the road. We had to leave a day early to bus down to UMBC because of weather. And it was, it's that time of year. You know, everyone's a little tired at this point of the year. And and then with our schedule with three in a row and we played all eight of our road games, with two weeks left in the season. So we've been on the road quite a bit. And so just to give them a couple days off and then get back to nice 2-hour practices and get back to working on some fundamentals and things that we haven't been able to do for a while.
Even though you were successful against Stony Brook the first time down there, will things be different with Anthony in the lineup this time?
No doubt. I mean, they're going to be they're playing well and they're really shooting from three, which hasn't been their strength this season. But the last couple of games, they've almost 50% from three. And so they'll be, we'll get their best shot on Saturday. And so, coming off the bye week, you never know how it's going to be. But we're going to have our hands full on Saturday. We're going to need to play really well.
Earlier this season, John, you said that this might be the best perimeter defensive team you've had. On the road trip, though, two teams dropped 12 threes on you. Was that just – and you won both those games.
Yeah.
What's maybe going on there?
We're not as good defensively as we've been earlier in the year and that really struggling some guys to guard the ball. And, again, I'm not sure what that is, maybe just guys are tired or not concentrating as much or – But for whatever reason, we kind of lost our way defensively, and so we'll have to get that back. And that's what we've been focused on this week.
What do you make of the point guard situation, namely sharing and splitting some time between Steph and Ben?
Robin's been our starting point guard for most of the year, and Ernie's played there at times and Steph at times and Benny obviously started last game. And so, that's a position we need some, a little more from, quite frankly. Teams aren't guarding Robin we gotta make them pay for that. And so, that's something that we're evaluating to figure out what the best lineups are here down the stretch to give us the best opportunity to be successful on both sides of the ball. So that's an ongoing discussion with the staff and practice is a big part of that. So by the end of this week, hopefully, we'll have a clear picture on what the rotations are going to look like.
Does that fall into any potential tweaks offensively in the final stretch here?
We're absolutely just trying to, we've been going through a lot of film as a staff and just continuing to try to, put our guys in the position to be successful, obviously against UMBC, we've struggled to score but we've also been, from a efficiency and statistics standpoint, the best offensive team in the league too. So, you don't want to overreact to one game or to one team, we're certainly, and we always are trying to evolve and change and do its best to fit our personnel and you know, with a young team like we have had, you know, we went back and watched a BU game, the first game of the year, and, you know, you can see how much more fresh the young guys look, and it's interesting. So we're just constantly trying to evaluate where our guys are right now and give them the best chance by changing whatever we need to.
Is that unusual to look at film way back?
No, but, you know, with this bye coming at the time it came, it's been nice to be able to practice, but also as a staff be able to really evaluate a lot of different things and you know, prepare for the stretch run here.
Is that a, you mentioned a couple of times about guys maybe being tired and the long season, young team, that whole combination.
Yeah.
Young guys, even the rigor last year, are playing more minutes than they did, yeah. More responsibility. The freshmen, it's the first time they've experienced, yeah, anything like this. Is that a concern at the end of the season going into the playoffs that the tank might be?
Yeah, I mean, I hope not. I mean, it's the same for a lot of teams. You know, there's some, we have a lot of young guys in this league, so it shouldn't be, but you're right. You know, most of the freshmen I haven't been through a season this long and grueling, and the sophomores haven't either, really. And even guys like Sam Dingba, who's a fifth-year senior, he's never played this much in college either. So, you know, so it's a reality of it. It's not an excuse. It's just you can clearly see, though, when you watch, you know, last couple games and watch games from November, December, it's different pop to our guys. And so, you know, hopefully this week, you know, and a lot of it to me is just we just haven't practiced in the last month, really, very much due to injuries. We don't have, you know, we've got enough guys, and then the travel / game schedule. So, you know, I'm hoping this week we can, you know, get some conditioning in and get back to some fundamentals and really kind of just hit the reset button a little bit.
And with that said, do you feel like that, you know, if you're searching for an energy boost or a motivating factor, that the guys, all you got to do is win Saturday and this is, you know, and this is taken care of,
yep,
you know, and the first goal is done?
Yeah, I mean, the guys aren't going to need much motivation this time of year. I mean, it's right out in front of us at this point. And so I expect us to play well on Saturday and play hard, and it should be a really good game. You know, but our guys would be motivated and excited.
You mentioned you want the guys to make the extra pass against Stony Brook, kind of break down the defense. Is it kind of a different case with Robin, where he seems like a pass-first guy? You said you want him to take advantage of more opportunities.
Yeah, I mean, like the first Stony Brook game, he had a bunch of point-blank layups at the rim that he missed, you know, so he needs to score a little bit to set up his passing. So he's, you know, he's like you said, he is a pass first kind of point guard with good size. So we're just continuing to work with him on finishing, and he usually has a nice size advantage over most of the guys that are guarding him. So he should be able to walk guys down to the paint and go up and score. So that would be huge if he can provide that consistently.
Has there been any specific point of emphasis in practice?
No, just really, I mean, yes. I mean, it's really getting back to the fundamentals and just, you know, just kind of hitting the, you know, like I said, the reset button to a degree. When you're not practicing much and then each game you're changing, you know, your scheme based on the opponent and stuff like that, you can get farther and farther away from the core of your system, you know, and I think that happens quite a bit, but with a younger team, you can see how it's, you know, you need that practice time to kind of get it back a little bit and to the foundation, and so we've been able to do that this week, and that's really been, you know, our emphasis and just trying to clean things up a little bit on each side, and now that we've played everybody twice pretty much, except a couple teams, you know, starting to look forward to the playoffs and what matchups may be. You know, we're certainly trying to get out in front of all that so that, you know, we can have the best opportunity to win.
Thanks, JB.
All right, thanks, guys. Girls.
Ready for Ski or Ram on here?
I'm getting there.
Who's shooting that?
Sort of a combination of people.
Yeah.
Peter and myself and Turner Sports hires a crew.
And you already have this nice zip up.
Coach kind of just said you probably don't need much motivation for Saturday, especially what's in front of you. But win on Saturday, you could win. You guys could be home for five straight.
Yeah, obviously we know what's at stake on Saturday. We don't need any motivation to get up for a sold-out crowd of Patrick and play against Stony Brook. So for a chance to win regular season title and to be home for that long. So, yeah, we don't need any motivation. I think I'll be ready and the guys will be ready to play on Saturday.
How do you create shots against a Stony Brook team that limits its opponents to under 30% from three?
I think driving kick is probably the biggest way we can create shots. Stony Brook is very good. Defensively, they really pack the paint and have really good shot blockers at the rim, so they make it really hard to score. So just being unselfish and driving and kick probably is one of the biggest. And playing off Lamb, too. When you feed Lamb, kind of moving off of his drives and his post-ups are probably the best way to create open shots.
That's something you didn't have with the first time you played them down there. Anthony wasn't even in the lineup. You guys were able to go down and get the win. So, obviously, you've got to be feeling good to be home and have him there as well.
Yeah. It's going to feel great to be home and have Anthony up against Stony Brook, and I'm excited.
Becker mentioned that you guys have kind of had some bouts up and down defensively throughout the season. Could this potentially be the rejuvenation you need against a Stony Brook team who you know is strong defensively?
Yeah, I think this week of practice is kind of our rejuvenation. I think we haven't had, in the past couple of weeks, a lot of time to get better. In practice and individually. So I think this week has been really good for us to kind of get rejuvenated, get refreshed, and, ready to go for the stretch run.
Coach talked about, just the overall energy, especially on this, a challenge of a three-game road trip. And this late in the season, the sophomores, even when we were here last year, they're playing more minutes than they ever had. The freshmen, this is the first time they've experienced. Guys like you and Everett, Anthony, you know the grind. But do you feel like the energy level going into this last week is where it should be, and how important maybe was that bye on this midweek bye?
Yeah, very important. Every freshman goes through a freshman wall, and the guys that haven't been here, kind of feel it on their body a little bit more than upperclassmen. And like I said, this week has been very important for our group, and for the freshmen and sophomores, it's their first time kind of going through this thing. And so as an upperclassman, I got to do my job and my role to help them along, and to they know what's at stake and everything, but just help them get there.
What sort of tips or advice have you given some of the younger guys getting through the freshman wall, so to speak?
Just staying level-headed and not put too much pressure on yourself. I feel like as a young guy, you put a lot of pressure on yourself to perform, and it can lead to bad performances. So just keeping them calm and understand that at the end of the day, it's just a game, and give everything you have for your teammates.
You think that this year's team is much better than the last 2 years, especially now that TBA?
I'm not going to answer that question.
All set. Thanks, sir.
Yep.
Thank you, guys.
One of these young guys, these freshmen, who's playing a lot of minutes, playing big roles, never experienced this before. What have you learned about yourself as the season's progressed, and where do you feel your energy level is heading into this last few deep runs?
I think, like Ernie said, definitely some of the guys, the younger guys, have hit a wall at some point. And I think we just, the coaches and the other leaders of the team, just keep telling us to just keep pushing on and letting us know how good we are. So I think that kind of helps us keep playing.
Kind of facilitating the game from the guard position, how would you evaluate how you and some of your teammates have really shared a lot of that time despite you getting most of the starts?
I think it really doesn't matter who's in the game, whether it's me, Ben, Ev, Steph, it doesn't matter. I mean, I think we all want to win. It's the main goal, is win a championship, so we're all in for that.
Obviously, I know this is your first time doing it, but you've kind of seen it through your brothers and such. You know, one win in the next two pretty much solidifies five straight home games for you guys. Coming off that road trip, that's got to feel pretty nice.
Oh, definitely. You know, with the one goal in mind, just winning a championship, I think this is one step closer to win it. You know, solidifying home court would be big.
You mentioned the freshman wall. How do you fight through something like that when you don't really have much time and each game means a lot right now?
I think kind of you can build confidence back up in practice. I think confidence is probably the biggest thing about hitting that wall, is keep going through it and just kind of just telling yourself how good you are and how good you have been before. So I think that's what the main thing is.
This team as a whole kind of need a reset this week?
I think, yeah, we definitely needed this practice, these past couple of practices, to kind of restart ourselves and get going like we were earlier in the season.